Hello everyone, welcome to today's lecture on half-life of drugs. This is a part of circular accessories in pharmacology with me, Sanjay Dakshat. So let's look into what half-life of drugs refers to. Plasma half-life, it is the time taken for the plasma concentration of the drug to be reduced to half of its original value. Let us look at the given picture out here. The picture on the left, you can see that the initial concentration of the drug is 16 microgram per ml, and then in 4 hours it reduces down to 8 microgram per ml. Again, you can see that the slope is constant, right? So you can see that from 8 it goes down to 4 microgram per ml in another 4 hours, and similarly from 4 it goes down to 2 microgram per ml in another 4 hours. So the half-life refers to the, as in the definition above, we have said that half-life is the time taken for the plasma concentration of the drug to be reduced to half of its original value, right? So if we take the original value as 16, then half-life is the time for the concentration of the drug to be reduced to 8. From 16, it reduces to 8. So the half-life is 4 hours. Since this follows first order kinetics, you can see that at any time you can look at the concentration and then see at which time it comes to half the initial concentration. Let us take the concentration at time 4 hour, right, which is 8 microgram per ml, and then again if we see the point at which it comes to 50%, that is 4 microgram per ml, then it's again 4 hours. This is the one that follows first order kinetics, right? But then not every drug follows first order kinetics. Some drugs, they are also known to follow zero order kinetics, and zero order kinetics is the one where T half increases with the dose because the clearance progressively decreases as the dose is increased. And zero order kinetics is seen with alcohol. It is seen with any drugs when they are given in toxic concentrations, then it follows the zero order kinetics because the body has got a certain set of enzymes that can help clear with metabolism and clearance of the drug. If you give way too high a dose, then normally, even if the drug would be cleared by first order kinetics, it would jump to the zero order kinetics. In zero order kinetics, the T half increases with dose and decreases with the decreasing concentration. You can calculate the T half as in the initial concentration by 2k, and which is 0.5 initial concentration by K. K is the elimination constant out here. Similarly, in case of first order kinetics, the T half remains constant, we have seen in the above picture, right? And it is independent of the initial concentration. So T half equals to 0.693 by K. It only takes into account the elimination rate constant K. Here, in case of zero order kinetics, you see that CO has got a role because we said earlier that it increases with increasing dose, right? So it has got a positive role, the dose has got a positive role, and therefore the initial concentration has got a role. Whereas in case of first order kinetics, the concentration does not have any role, and therefore it is independent of the initial concentration. Let us have a look at the graph of both the types. Okay, here what you can see is that this is the graph that has been plotted for a zero order reaction, and this is the graph that has been plotted for a first order reaction. Here you can note that the first half-life is relatively long as compared to the second half-life and the third half-life. Here you can see that in case of first order reaction, the length of the half-life is constant, right? As we had seen in the earlier picture, all the three half-lives have got the same length, whereas here in case of the zero order reaction, the first half-life is a lot longer as compared to second half-life and as compared to the third half-life. Since I did not plot the graph myself and I got it from the internet, the time has been mentioned in second. Normally, in case of medicines, it is in hours, or it could be in minutes, right? This kind of very, very short half-lives can be seen with radioactive compounds. So, with this said earlier, T half of zero order process is not constant but proportional to initial concentration of the drug and inversely proportional to the zero order rate constant KO. Zero order kinetics, the T half increases with dose because clearance progressively decreases as the dose is increased. So, you can see that in higher doses, the T half is longer, and in smaller doses or small concentrations, the T half also decreases. And this can be seen in this case, you need to use constant IV infusion of the drug and controlled drug delivery systems like IM implants and osmotic pumps, which pump the drug very slowly in the body over a long period of time. In first order kinetics, the T half remains constant, we have seen this, right? And it is independent of the initial concentration of the drug. This is because the volume of distribution and clearance do not change with dose in many drugs. Most of the pharmacokinetic processes, ADME, they follow the first order kinetics. ADME stands for absorption, distribution, metabolism, and elimination. So, for most of the drugs, they follow the first order kinetics because the drugs that are used at therapeutic levels are normally in low dose, and in low dose, our body's metabolizing systems and elimination systems, everything, we've got ample of enzymes that are responsible, that are present in our body. But then when you give in way too high a dose, in toxic dose, then it goes, jumps to the zero order kinetics again. Have a look at this graph. Here, the plasma concentration versus time curve. This is the linear concentration scale. You can see there is 0 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 8 and 10, right? So this is a linear concentration scale, whereas this very thing is a logarithmic concentration scale. 0 to 1, 1 to 10, 10 to 100 will be gone there. So in equal spacing, you can see the difference of 10 out here. 10 times it is being multiplied by 10, while here you can see addition of 2 units, right? So this is a logarithmic concentration scale and this is a linear concentration scale. We call this kind a semi-log because here you see that this is log, well, this is linear, right? This is linear in both the places, so this is linear concentration scale and we call this semi-log or logarithmic concentration scale. Here, two different drugs are given, right? A and B, and they differ only in the elimination rate constant KEL. In that, at first, the same dose of the drug is given, so they have got same volume of distribution. That is, therefore, they have got same initial concentration. But because they differ in the elimination rate constant, the elimination rate constant of A is 0.2 per hour and of B is 0.05 per hour. So because the elimination rate constant of A is relatively high, you see that the graph has decreased drastically, right? The concentration has decreased drastically in the graph as compared for B, where there is relatively gradual decrease because of lesser elimination rate constant. And here you can see again there is another curve called B dash, right? This curve B dash, it shows the plasma concentration time curve for a small dose of B. Here the dose of A and B both were same, but then here in case of B dash, the dose of the drug is lesser, but nevertheless it is the same drug, right? So when you give lesser dose, which have got same elimination rate constant, they decrease in the same manner. So you can see that the T half for both B and B dash, they are the same. Thank you everyone. Happy learning. This is a part of Cheat Sheet of Pharmacology at MCQ Pool. Thank you.